He's good.
Dobre. Dobre choice.
Alex is talking.
Yeah.
We will get the deal and the details.
Tony, thank you very much for this kind words. So you are somebody who is very, very normal.
Ambasadore!
Courageous, amazing women with us in Strasbourg at the Council of Europe. I would say it's even a historical moment because it is the first time we will listen from them about their struggle for justice. I'll be very brief and I let the time for dear Munira and dear Kada to tell you what they wish to share with you. Once again, thank you so much for coming here. For the launch of this, I would say, modest exhibition with a special message. Message about the truth, reconciliation, and the importance of truth for the future generations in the Western Balkans and beyond. I can only imagine, and we can only imagine, how difficult it is at this time of the year for Kada, for Munira, and many others that stayed at home in Bosnia and Herzegovina to remember what actually happened 24 years ago. Next year we will mark 25th anniversary of the genocide in Srebrenica. Some still do not know about this. Some still choose not to know for different reasons. But we need to continue talking about truth, about justice, and the importance of justice to be served. If we want to have peace, if we want to have generations that are building bridges and working on something that is important, then we also need to recognize what happened and not to deny it. The culture of denial is something that is already deeply rooted in the Western Balkans. And I see, as the Council of Europe Commissioner for Human Rights, the importance of talking about these issues at the Council of Europe, and the leading, as we call ourselves, leading human rights body. So we need to prove that we are really a leading human rights body in the world, or at least in Europe, if we recognize this kind of events. We need to fight, as I already stated, denial of genocide. This is all the more important because in the region this culture is something that we are facing all the time. Only and only by educating young generations about the past in a truthful way can be a genuine reconciliation. You, mothers, are calling on the Council of Europe to mark 11th of July as an official Remembrance Day of Srebrenica genocide. Our Secretary General went to Srebrenica in order to mark this important day. But it would be also good to have this place as a place where we mark it for the future generations. For too long, the international community has looked away. And in this plea of Mothers of Srebrenica, I join my voice to yours. And I also very much support marking this day as the day of remembering. The time has come to take sides and march with you to replace the seeds of hate with those of justice. Thank you very much.
Uvaženi skupe, poštovane ekscelencije, dame i gospodo, hvala vam što ste danas došli ovdje. Hvala našoj komesarki za ljudska prava, Dunji, koja je omogućila da danas možemo da kažemo nekoliko riječi vezano za našu borbu za istinu i pravdu.
Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, dear friends, thank you very much for coming, and I would also like to thank our dear Commissioner for Human Rights for making it possible for us to come here and tell you about what we're doing in our quest for the truth and for justice.
Mi majke koje smo izgubile svoju djecu, svoje najmilije, 24 godine se borimo za istinu, za pravdu. Naš je najveći moto, pronaći kosti vlastog djeteta.
We, the mothers who lost their children, who lost their loved ones. For 25 years we have been fighting, and our greatest desire for some of us is still simply to find the bones of our children.
Pošto znamo nepravda koja nam je nanešena 95. godine na kraju 20. i na početku 21. vijeka, znamo da je Europa velikim brojem odgovorna za to.
We know that what happened to us in 1995 is great injustice that happened at the end of the 20th, at the onset of the 21st century. We know that to a large extent Europe is responsible for that.
Jel nisu ništa učinili da se spriječi genocid na kraju 20. vijeka?
They did nothing to prevent this genocide from happening at the end of the 20th century.
U Srebrenici 95. godine je ubijeno po našoj evidenciji za 3 dana 10.701 osoba.
According to our records, in 3 days of the month of July 1995, 10,701 persons were killed.
Meni su ubili 22 člana moje uže familije.
22 members of my immediate family were killed.
Ostalo je 5,500 djece bez jednog ili bez oba roditelja.
5,500 children were left without one or both parents.
Ta djeca su gledala kad im ubijaju oca, siluju majku ili sestru.
Those children witnessed their fathers killed, their mothers and their sisters raped.
Ali ta djeca nisu posegnula ni za osvetom, ani za mržnjom.
But those children never resorted to either revenge or hatred.
Često puta kažem, to je naš uspjeh, uspjeh majki Bošnjakinja.
I often say, that is our success, the success of the Bosniak mothers.
Da sad imamo jako dosta naše djece koja govore nekoliko strani jezika, koji su doktori, inženjeri i koji su ponos ne samo Bosne, nego cijele Evrope.
It is our success that today we have a young generation of doctors, of engineers, who are the pride and joy of not only Bosnia and Herzegovina, but elsewhere as well.
Još danas moram se sad zahvaliti ponovo našoj komesarki Dunji Mijatović, koja je glavna za vijeće u Vijeću Evrope za ljudska prava.
Again, I must thank our dear Commissioner for Human Rights, Mrs. Dunja Mijatović.
Da kažemo da je prošlo 24 godine da Vijeće Evrope nije donijelo dan žalosti, da proglasi dan žalosti 11. juli, koji je vrlo važan ne samo za nas majke, ne za našu djecu, nego za cijeli, čitav svijet, za Evropu koja se bori za ljudska prava.
It's been 20 years and the Council of Europe has not yet declared the 11th of July a day of remembrance of the day of genocide, the remembrance against genocide, something that's important for everyone, for not just us, but for Europe, for the world.
Nadam se, ako Bog da 25. godišnicu, da nećemo dočekati bez toga datuma i bez tog obilježavanja i da ćemo dobiti zakon o zabrani negiranja genocida. Ne smijemo kroz te negiranje da rušimo ono što je donio sud pravde, sud u Hagu i sud u Bosni i Hercegovini. Moramo štititi presude koje su donesene sa istinom i sa dokazima.
So we hope that this will become reality by our 25th anniversary, which is coming up. We hope that there will be a Remembrance Day, and we also hope that we will eventually have a law on prohibition of genocide denial. We must ensure that no one denies genocide, that no one denies judgments reached by the International Court of Justice, by ICTY in The Hague and by the courts in Bosnia and Herzegovina. We cannot deny justice.
Zato, dame i gospodo, i od vas tražimo da dignete svoj glas, da nam pomognete da dođemo do istine, do pravde, da se ne zaboravi i da se nikad, nigdje ne ponovi Srebrenica. Hvala.
So, ladies and gentlemen, join us. We want you to join your voices with ours in our joint quest for the truth, for justice, and to make sure that what happened in Srebrenica will never, ever happen again anywhere in the world to anyone. Thank you very much.
Što više majki u ovom svijetu, da nikad nijedna majka ne pati ko što patimo mi. Sve su majke, majke, i moramo se tako odnositi prema njima.
We're calling on all mothers to help us to make sure there's no mother in the world who will ever suffer the way we mothers of Srebrenica have suffered. A mother is a mother, and no mother should suffer like this. Thank you.
Uvaženi prisutni, gospodo, svi koji ste došli danas ovdje, jako smo zahvalni vama da čujete bar nešto malo o nama, o organizaciji Pokret Majke Glava Srebrenice i Žepa, o našoj borbi za istinu i pravdu. Munira je već rekla zbog čega smo ovdje, zbog naše tragedije koju smo doživjeli u svojoj zemlji od svog naroda, pod prisustvom UN-a, pod prisustvom, pred prisustvom razni IFOR-a, sporova, razni organizacija iz Europe, iz Amerike, koji su pratili dešavanja u Bosni i Hercegovini. Ko je bio agresor? Sa čim su nas tukli? I zbog čega? Ubili su nas zbog toga što smo bosanski muslimani, narode iz Europe, rukovodioci koji se brinu za ljudska prava, za demokratiju. Nemojte dijeliti ljude po religiji, po naciji. Dijelite ih samo kao ljudska bića.
Dear friends, thank you very much for coming here. Thank you for gathering and giving us this opportunity to tell you about what it is that we're doing, how we're fighting, or how we're struggling to find the truth, to make it public, how we're struggling to find justice. We want to make sure that this tragedy doesn't happen, because it is important for everyone to know that we suffered the tragedy in our own country by our own people, but we also suffered the tragedy with the presence of the UN, of IFOR, of ESFOR, of various international organizations, organizations from Europe, from America. They saw what was happening in Bosnia and Herzegovina. They did nothing to prevent it. They knew who the aggressor was. They knew what they were firing at us. But let me tell you this. The only reason they did it was because we were Bosnian Muslims. So I'm addressing you, the people of Europe, you, the leaders, you, those who fight for human rights and democracy. And I'm telling you this. Do not divide people by their religion, by their ethnicity. If you divide them, do it only as human beings.
Svi smo svjedoci da smo u Bosni i u bivšoj Jugoslaviji živjeli zajedno. Nisu nam smetale ni vjere, ni običaji. Bili smo jedan narod bivše Jugoslavije. Ako se moralo izdijeliti na republike, na države, zašto nismo ostali u Bosni kao država? Zašto su se umiješali ljudi koji misle da treba izbrisati muslimane iz ovog dijela Europe? Narode, Europo, ekscelencije, rukovodioci koji donosite odluka danas, razmislite dobro, vrate nam državu Bosnu i Hercegovinu. Vrate Bosancima mir i spokojstvo i vratite nam ljepotu života, mi smo je imali. A ako sam ja muslimanka, što kome smetam? Nikad muslimani u Bosni nisu započinjali ratove. Nikad nisu htjeli živjeti sami. Nikad nisu oduzimali tuđe teritorije. To je poznato kroz historiju. Nepravedno smo likvidirani. Nepravedno smo osuđeni. Nepravedno da nas patimo.
Many of you know very well that custom, if the country, if the state of Yugoslavia had to fall apart, if we were divided into republics that became states, why didn't we get to keep the state of Bosnia and Herzegovina? Why were there suddenly those who thought that Muslims should be erased from this part of Europe? Why did they interfere? So, the people of Europe, excellencies, decision makers, think about this. Give us back the state of Bosnia and Herzegovina. Give us our peace of mind. Give us the beauty of life, for we did have it. Muslims in Bosnia and Herzegovina never had a problem with anyone. Muslims in Bosnia and Herzegovina never initiated any conflict, never sought to take anything from anyone, land or anything else. Why not live the way we did? We were unfairly attacked. We want to live in harmony.
Danas patim, mog sina nema, ubili su ga. Dvije kosti sam samo ukopala. Mog muža nema, mog druga i prijatelja. Moju braću, moji 56 u familiji, i moj narod srednički i moj narod bosanski, ubijeni. I danas ih tražimo po grobnicama, iskomadani, rastureni, mašinama usitnjene kosti.
Today, my port is not there. He was killed. My brothers were killed. 56 members of my family were killed. My people of Srebrenica, my people.
Nakon 24 godine, oni koji su ih smjestili u grobnice šute, oni koji su gledali također šute. Sateliti čiji su snimali također šute. Narode, zašto šutimo? Treba istina. Mi majke, me svoje djece, ustale smo da se borimo za istinu i pravdu. Da izneseno pred lice svijeta tu istinu, jer nam treba takav život.
So, for 24 years there are silent. Those whose satellites make pictures of what was happening are silent.
Ovdje smo sa izložbom dokumentarne fotografije kroz naš rad posle ratni do sad. Nekoliko fotografija, mi toga imamo možda i 1000. Gdje smo zabilježili naš dosadašnji rad. Osjetili smo kao majke da imamo pravo na pravdu. Neću samo da plačem za svojim sinom, hoću da se borim. Pomozite nam koji možete pomoći. Vratite život Bosni i Hercegovini.
So because we decided that as mothers we have a right to justice. I as a mother and many others, we don't want to just cry, we want to fight. We want to fight for the truth and for justice. Those of you who can, help us in our fight. Thank you.
This is a moving moment for all of us, also for me. As a predecessor of Dunja, some 10 years ago, I went on mission to the country, the Bosnia. And of course, one of the main objects was to find out as much as possible about the truth of the horrible genocide that took place around 50 years earlier. I met the mothers and amazingly they inspired me with their spirit. Of course they were grieved, but they asked for truth and they were fighting against impunity. At the same time, they talked about peace for the future. They were not out for revenge, they were out for truth. Have they got the truth? Not yet. There are still disappeared people. Some of the perpetrators have been brought to justice, but not all of them. And I think that we here, in other parts of Europe, have not really understood the lessons that we learned from what happened. The lessons we learned. There were people employed to protect the people against any violence in Bosnia at the time. They were close to the area where more than 8,000 people were killed. It was a genuine genocide, and it was confirmed by the highest level of justice. It was a genocide, not talking about genocide, it was a genocide. What did we learn from this? What was our real participation in this? Why could we not protect this? There is a need of remembering, and there is a need to continue to discuss what went wrong and our own responsibility in this. Therefore, it's so important that we now agree that there will be an annual event of remembrance. We have to fight against deniers and forgettingness. We have to remember these and try to all the time discuss what can we do in order to absolutely avoid this kind of genocide in the future, even on our own continent. It's great that our ladies have come here to teach us about that, and their spirit should be an inspiration for all of us.
Dear ladies and gentlemen, dear Secretary General of the Council of Europe, and the candidates for the Secretary General of the Council of Europe, distinguished colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for kind coming on this exhibition. Probably the best word for the exhibition is a silence and a commemoration. 24 years after the genocide, I would like to repeat, genocide in the end of the 20th century, we have nothing to add to the word of Mother Munira, to the word of the Mother Kada. Tragedy which is unbelievable in the end of the 20th century in the Europe, warning once again that something like that is impossible, unfortunately possible in my country. What is the main message of the Mother Munira and Kada? Is rehabilitation, reconvalescence, and live together. Nevertheless, what happened? Mother has a right for the true, but my country also needs a chance for the common life. Nevertheless, who is from who ethnic group, from which believers group, religion one, and who socially become on the which part of the Bosnia and Herzegovina. Bosnia and Herzegovina need to be modern, civilized European country with rule of law, with a democracy, with the human rights. This is a free elementary pillars for common living in Bosnia and Herzegovina. Thank you for the Madame Dunja Mijatović and the Commissariat for the Human Rights of the Council of Europe for these small remembers, and I am looking forward for all citizens of Bosnia and Herzegovina, especially for young generation, to build modern country, to build country which are not discussing without and about presence in Council of Europe. For the country where the delegation to the Council of Europe will be elementary thing, an elementary part of presentation of my country in this high house. I believe that coming the better future for the Bosnia, future for understanding, future of the common life, and I'm looking forward for that. All my empathy to Munira and Kada, and my condolences once again 20 years for later.
This was it. Please have a look at some of the photographs that mothers brought and wanted you to see it. Of course, this is just a start when it comes to the work of my office in relation to transitional justice in general. And I thank you once again for coming and for listening to what Munira and Kada have to say. I think it's important to remember and even to try to digest it over days, in order to come back and once again talk about these issues that are painful, not easy, but so important for the well-being of our societies and also for the organizations like the Council of Europe. Thank you very much.